Budweiser, the king of beers, presents Kiner's Corner in its 30th anniversary season. Kiner's Corner is brought to you by Budweiser, the king of beers, with that clean, crisp, cold taste. Nothing beats a Bud. By Mitsubishi, bringing you a full line of award-winning automobiles. Mitsubishi, the word is getting around. And by Snapple Natural Beverages, made from the best stuff on earth. Well, hi, everybody. Welcome to Kiner's Corner here in Montreal. And we have as our special guest in the program, Todd Huntley, who hasn't been well lately. But he certainly got well here today as he had a couple of big hits for the New York Mets as the Mets won it by a score of 11-6. And Todd, you haven't been playing because you've been under the weather with the bug, and you finally got back in action, and you started a big rally for the Mets that saw them come back to win the ball game, scoring four runs when you started that rally with a base hit.
Yeah, Ralph, I have been under weather. I've had the flu for about a week now. I started to feel better last couple days, and yeah, it feels good to get back in the lineup.
One of the things that happened here today, you hit very well from the right-hand side of the plate against left-hand pitching. Of course, you've been really noted more for being a better left-hand batter. Is that really a true recognition of your talent?
Well, I think the average from the left side might be better. I feel good hitting from the right side now, and it's just a matter of, you know, getting the at-bats from either side, and, you know, the feeling at the plate will come.
Well, it certainly did come. Your next time up in the eighth inning, when you let off the inning in this ball, your first home run as a right-hand batter, your second in the major leagues, and there was no doubt about it.
Well, it felt good when I hit it, Ralph. It was to the deep center, and it felt good when I hit it, but, I haven't had many at-bats, so I just ran as hard as I could.
Well, you don't have to run very hard there. The home run coming off of former teammate Doug Simons, and Doug now has an earned run average of 216. That's 216.00, and you helped contribute to that.
Wow, I didn't know that, Ralph. Doug is, he's a great guy and a good friend, but, when you get between the lines, you're competing.
What happens now when you get back to New York? Does your father, Randy Huntley, who was a great major league catcher, give you a call and tell you about what went on? Does he watch the games on television?
Yeah, as much as he can, Ralph. He gets to see the games. I don't know. I don't know if he is going to call me or not. I'll probably talk to him within the next couple of days.
How many home runs are you behind your dad now?
A lot, I believe.
Yeah, I think so. A few, because he could hit that ball well,
yeah,
too. And Todd, a good game today. You came in the ball game and caught the latter part of the ball game, catching Anthony Young. He gave up only one hit. And Young in relief, winning his second game of the year, and you called the pitches.
Thank you, Ralph.
It's a win for the New York Mets, and Todd Huntley certainly contributed to that win with a 2-for-2 day and a home run. And Todd, thank you for coming on.
Thanks, Ralph.
We'll be right back after this message from Mitsubishi. Well, the Mets won it by a score of 11-6. It was all Easter eggs on the scoreboard until the fourth inning. There had been seven walks, but no base hits. And then Johnson led off the fourth inning with an infield base hit, followed by Eddie Murray's single. And then Murray was picked off at first base with the first out. Here is Gallagher with an RBI double down the left field line to score Johnson from third. The Mets take the lead 1-0. The Mets have not lost this year when they have had the lead in the ballgame from the start. And now it's Magadan coming up with a single here to score Gallagher, and it makes it a 2-0 ballgame for the New York Mets. Magadan with that RBI, picking up his second RBI of the year. Gallagher scoring. And then Magadan scores on the air here on the bouncing ball, the ball thrown away. Magadan comes in to score, and the Mets lead by a score of 3-0. In the bottom of the fourth inning, Walker comes up with an RBI single off the fastball thrown by Sid Fernandez. It scores Calderon, and it makes it a 3-1 ball game. And now Wallach going all the way around. Should say Walker going all the way around to third in the play and gets in safely. And he scores on the sack fly by Wallach. And that makes it a 3-2 game in favor of the New York Mets. So with a score at 3-2 in favor of the Mets, Grissom hits a 2-run home run. And it puts the Montreal Expos up by a score of 4-3. It scores Wallach, who had walked, and Sid Fernandez Now on the losing side of the ballgame, he had struck out 10 batters to this point and had struck out the two previous batters before the home run to Grissom. Grissom now with three home runs against the Mets. Ojo, though, with a bases-clearing double, and it gets by the left fielder Calderon, and Ojo comes in to score on the air, and the Mets get four runs right here to get back in the lead, and they lead by a score of 7-4. Howard Johnson with three RBIs, and then Todd Huntley with a home run, his first as a New York Mets player from the right-hand side, his first this year, and his second his major league career, and that Mets now lead by a score of 8-4. They went on to win it by a score of 11-6 as Anthony Young picked up the victory in relief of Sid Fernandez, the Mets with a comeback victory. And when they have scored the first run of the ballgame, the Mets now have a record of 6-0, and they have won the series against Montreal, winning two of the three ball games. We'll be back after this word from Snapple. Well, the Mets won it here by a score of 11-6, and a lot of Easter eggs on that scoreboard as we check out the Mitsubishi National League scoreboard. Pittsburgh defeated Philadelphia by a score of 11-0. Walk started that game but didn't get credit for it as he left before completing five innings of work. Pittsburgh now has won six in a row. Their record now stands at 9-2. And no score, San Diego and Houston, that game in the bottom of the 11th inning. St. Louis defeated Chicago by a score of 4-3. St. Louis 3.5 games back of the winning Pittsburgh Pirates, and they stay in third place, tied with Montreal. And also Atlanta playing against the Dodgers later on. That's a night game in L.A. And San Francisco leading Cincinnati by a score of 7-0 that game in the top of the fifth inning. Checking out the American League scoreboard, the Mitsubishi American League scoreboard. Yankees defeated Cleveland by a score of 5-3. Boston over Toronto by a score of 5-4. Toronto's third loss, they had won 10. And it's Seattle 9 and Milwaukee 8, that game in the bottom of the sixth inning. Baltimore defeated Detroit 3-2. And it's Chicago, the White Sox over Minnesota 4-1. California scheduled to play in Kansas City. That game rained out, and Texas leading Oakland by a score of 3-2. And that game in the bottom of the fourth inning. So that's the Mitsubishi scoreboard. We'll be back right after this message from Budweiser. Well, the Mets won it by a score of 11-6, the Snapple turning point of the ball game. With the Mets trailing 4-3, Howard Johnson with the bases loaded, doubles down the left field line. Three runs come in to score, and when the ball gets away from Calderon in left field, Johnson comes in to score, and the Mets take the lead by a score of 7-3. They added four more in the eighth inning and won it by a score of 11-6. So our Snapple turning point of the ball game, the double by Howard Johnson. He had five RBIs in the ball game. And the sharp pitcher of the year, you probably wondered who it was in 1991, and it is Doc Gooden. So Doc Gooden, the sharp pitcher of the year of 1991. And here's Doc with Sharp's Tom Borgano, and he's being presented the award for being the pitcher of the year. Congratulations to Doc Gooden. So the Mets have won it by a score of 11-6, and we'll be right back after this message from Mitsubishi. Well, a week ahead for the New York Mets, a big schedule with the Cardinals and the Philadelphia Phillies. The Mets will have tomorrow as an off day. Then Tuesday night, it'll be the Mets against St. Louis. It'll be Doc Gooden on the mound Tuesday night. We'll be doing that game here on WWOR-TV. Then Wednesday night, the second game of that series, and Thursday afternoon, then the Mets go down to Philadelphia, and they'll play a three-game series with the Philadelphia Phillies Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Saturday and Sunday will be on WWOR-TV, so we hope you can be with us then. So once again, the final score.